Hello dear students, welcome to the Royal Palace PU College online classes. So in last class we have discussed about the difference between adsorption and absorption. So adsorption, so already we know about this definition of adsorption. It is a surface phenomenon. So whereas absorption, it is a bulk phenomenon. So and also the adsorption, so here what happened, I have given one example for this adsorption. So the surface phenomenon, that means what here, accumulation of ammonia gas on the surface of the what here, adsorbent. So whereas absorption, here what happened, penetration of molecule into the body of the other substance. So that process is called what here, absorption. So now here in today's session, so I am going to continue the same concept about this adsorption and absorption. Now already we discussed about the difference. Now here the concept, that is mechanism of the adsorption. So why the adsorption phenomenon can be takes place? So what is the exact mechanism behind the adsorption? So why the adsorption can be takes place? So the mechanism behind the adsorption is, so we know that the particle which is present inside the adsorbent, the particles which are surrounded by the same kind of the particle. So that means what here, inside the adsorbent, the particles which shows what here, balanced force of attraction. Now whereas the particle which are present at the surface of the adsorbent, these particle which possess what here, unbalanced forces of attraction. Here the particle which are present inside this, suppose consider this is an adsorbent. The particle here, we have what here, the particles inside the body, these particles which are surrounded by what here, same kind of particle. So that means what here, inside particle which possess what here, balanced force of attraction, whereas the particle which are present on the surface of this adsorbent, so these particle possess what here, unbalanced force of attraction. So this unbalanced force of attraction, that leads to what here, the adsorption process. That means what here, the balanced force of attraction which is shown by the particle which are present inside the adsorbent, and these particles which are present on the surface of the adsorbent, they will possess what here, unbalanced force of attraction. To balance this unbalanced force of attraction, so the particle which are present on the surface of the adsorbent, they will attract some adsorbent. Correct. To balance this unbalanced force of attraction, these particle get attract some adsorbent, hence the adsorption can be takes place. So thing is that the particle which are present on the surface of the adsorbent, they will possess what here, unbalanced force of attraction. To balance this unbalanced force of attraction, they will get what here, the particle will attract what here, adsorbent. So hence the adsorption can be takes place. So this is the exact mechanism behind the adsorption. So now I will move for the thermodynamic concept of the adsorption. So thermodynamics concept of the adsorption, or thermodynamics of adsorption. So adsorption, it is an exothermic reaction. Adsorption process, it is an exothermic reaction. That means what here, release of heat can be takes place. So now here the adsorption, so here what happen, when the adsorbent, that means what here, the particle which come in contact to the surface of this adsorbent, so this is an adsorbent. So already we discuss about this adsorbent means the substance which provide the space for the accumulation of particles. So there it is called what here, adsorbent. And the particle
which are present or accumulate on the surface of this adsorbent, these particles or molecules or molecular species are called what here? Adsorbate. Adsorbate. Okay. So these particle, when it comes contact to the surface of the adsorbent, so it release what here? Some amount of heat. It release some amount of heat. Hence, the adsorption process is an exothermic reaction. That means exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction. Adsorption process is an exothermic reaction. That means what here? There is a release of what here? Heat. During adsorption, there is a release of heat. Hence, the adsorption process is an exothermic reaction. So here, the exothermic reaction means there is a release of heat can be takes place. Hence, the delta H, that will becomes what here? Negative. Delta H, change in the enthalpy. Change in the enthalpy. Enthalpy, that will becomes what here? Negative. So why this is negative? That means what here? During adsorption, there is a release of what here? Heat can be takes place. Because the adsorption process is an exothermic reaction. Hence, the delta H becomes what here? Negative. And also, delta S, that is also equal to what here? Negative. That means what here? Delta S is change in entropy. Delta S means change in entropy. So, entropy means randomness. Here what happen? During adsorption, here the particle will be get what here? Randomly, they will show what here? Movement. So when it accumulate on the surface of this adsorbent, the randomness of this particle will be decreases. So movement of the particle will be decreases. Due to, you know that adsorption means the particle which get accumulate on the surface of this adsorbent. So for that reason, the molecule movement, I mean randomness what happened decreases. Okay, hence due to the randomness decreases, that means what here? The randomness of molecular species that will get what here? Reduced due to adsorption. Hence the delta S becomes what here? Negative. And the next one, the delta G. Delta G. So that is change in Gibbs free energy. Change in Gibbs. Change in Gibbs free energy. So always you have to remember that the all spontaneous reactions are the they will show what here? Delta, I mean negative. Spontaneous reactions, they will show what here? Change in Gibbs free energy is always negative. So this is the thermodynamic concept regarding what here? Absorption. Now here the absorption, it is a process. Here what happened? Adsorption, it is a process. After adsorption, there is a release of what here? Some amount of heat. Hence, that leads to what here? Change in the enthalpy, that will becomes what here? Negative. Due to adsorption, the randomness of the molecular species decreases. Hence, that change in entropy, that will becomes what here? Negative. And the spontaneous reactions, they have what here? Always change in Gibbs energies, always in negative. So the adsorption process is a spontaneous process. Hence the delta G that will becomes change in Gibbs energy becomes that will be equal to the negative. So this is thermodynamics concept regarding what here? Adsorption. So now I will move for the next one concept. So that is factors affecting the rate of the adsorption. Factors affecting the rate of the adsorption. Factors affecting the rate of adsorption. Rate of adsorption. So what are the factors which affects the rate of adsorption? The first one, surface area. The first factor, it is, that is surface area. Surface area. So already we discussed about this concept. As increase in the surface area of the adsorbent, more number of molecular species, I mean adsorbate that will accumulate on the surface of the adsorbent. That means what here? The adsorption depends on the surface area. As increase in the surface area, more number of molecular species adsorbate that will accumulate on the surface. As decrease in the surface area, lesser number of molecular species will be accumulate. Hence, the rate of adsorption will be decreases. That means what here? The rate of adsorption depends on the surface area. As increase in the surface area, rate of adsorption increases, or as decrease in the surface area, rate of adsorption will be decreases. Okay, the first factor, that is surface area. As increase in the surface area of the adsorbent, surface area of the adsorbent, increase in the rate of adsorption. That means what here? Surface area of the adsorbent, so that is directly proportional to the rate of the adsorption. Increase in the surface area of the adsorbent, more number of the adsorbate will be get accumulated. That means rate of adsorption increases. Suppose decrease in the surface area, so there is a less number of what here? Molecular species, that means adsorbate, that will accumulate. That means what here? There is a decrease in the rate of the adsorption. So next one concept, that is nature of gases. Easily liquefiable gases readily get adsorbed. So those gases which get easily liquefied, such gases that will get what here? Easily get adsorbed. That means what here? The rate of adsorption is more. So that in case of what here? Easily liquefiable gases. So example for easily liquefiable gases are ammonia, methane, SO2, sulfur dioxide. So these are the easily liquefiable gases which will get easily adsorbed on the surface of the what here? Adsorbent. So whereas non easily liquefiable gases are not get easily adsorbed. That means what here? Non easily liquefiable gases that reduce what here? Enanthe helbodu andre rate of the adsorption. So this is second one factor. Third one factor that is pressure. So the role of pressure in case of adsorption is, as increase in the pressure, rate of adsorption will be increases. Okay. So now here, next one, fourth one, temperature. So now here, the role of temperature in case of adsorption is, as increase in the temperature, the rate of adsorption that will decreases, because we know that here in case of adsorption, the adsorbate which accumulate on the surface of the adsorbent, consider this is duster which is act as an what here? Adsorbent. And the dust particle which get accumulate on the surface of this adsorbent, the dust particles, they are considered as what here? Adsorbent. Now what happen when we are going to increase the temperature, the adsorbate that will escape from the surface of this adsorbent. Hence, so to as increase in the temperature, the adsorbed molecule get escape. So that means what here? The rate of adsorption decreases. Okay.
Now the temperature role in case of what here? Rate of adsorption as increase in the temperature. As increase in the temperature, rate of adsorption decreases. Adsorption decreases. Next one, the last one factor, that is nature of the adsorbent. So already we discussed about this nature of the adsorbate. So that is nature of gases. Okay. So nature of the adsorbate. Here the nature of the adsorbent. So here the nature of the adsorbent. So especially solid. If an adsorbent having porous. The adsorption takes place easily. Adsorption takes place easily. That means what here? If an adsorbent having more porous, more number of adsorbate that will accumulate on the surface of this adsorbent, so that will increase the rate of adsorption. Okay, so the adsorbent, if having more porous, more adsorption can be takes place. That means what here? More porous, more adsorption can be takes place. So that means what here? The adsorbate having more porous, that is act as a good adsorbent. If the adsorbent having more porous, that is act as a good adsorbent, and that will increase what here? Rate of the adsorption. So these are the factors affecting the rate of adsorption. The first one, surface area. As increase in the surface area, rate of adsorption increases. Nature of this is gases means adsorbate. Nature of adsorbate. So that means what here? Easily liquefiable gases readily get adsorbed. So that means rate of adsorption increases. Whereas non-easily liquefiable gases are not get easily adsorbed. That means what here? Here the rate of adsorption decreases. In case of what here? Non-easily liquefiable gases. So for this example, non-easily liquefiable gases, hydrogen, so that is nitrogen. So these are the non-easily liquefiable gases that reduce what here? Rate of adsorption. In the third one, that is factor pressure. As increase in the pressure, the rate of reaction will be increases. And the fourth one factor, that is temperature. As increase in the temperature, decrease in the rate of the adsorption. And the last one factor, that is nature of the adsorbent. So here, if the adsorbent having more porous, that adsorbent, it is an act as a good adsorbent, and the adsorption will be increases. The rate of adsorption will be increases. So these are the factors affecting the rate of the adsorption. Okay. So now let us, I will move for the types of the adsorption. So here we have two types of adsorption. The one is physical adsorption, or it is also called what here? Physisorption. And the second one is chemical adsorption or chemisorption. The types of this adsorption mainly based on the force of attraction between adsorbate and adsorbent. Okay. So here the types of adsorption. So depending upon the forces of attraction between adsorbate and adsorbent, the adsorption process can be classified into two types. So the one is, so the based on nature of attractive force
between adsorbate and adsorbent. So already we know that the phenomenon of accumulation of adsorbate on the surface of the what here? Adsorbent. That is called what here? Adsorption. Now the species, the molecular species which get accumulate on the surface of, this is an adsorbent. The molecular species which accumulate on the surface of the adsorbent, they are called what here? Adsorbate. So already we discussed about this concept. Now adsorbent means the substance which provide a space for the accumulation of what here? Adsorbate or molecular species. That is called what here? Adsorbent. So now here for the accumulation of what here? Adsorbate on the surface of this adsorbent, there is a force of attraction between adsorbate and adsorbent. So without any force of attraction, the adsorbate will not accumulate on the surface of the adsorbent. There is a force of attraction between what here? Adsorbate and adsorbent. So based on the nature of the force of the attraction between adsorbate and adsorbent, the adsorption can be classified into two types. The one is physisorption or physical adsorption or physisorption, and second one is chemical adsorption or this is also called what here? Chemisorption. So these two types are mainly based on the nature of binding force between adsorbate and adsorbent. Now the first one, let us move one by one. So the first one, physical adsorption or physisorption. So what do you mean by physical adsorption or physisorption? Now here the physisorption means the adsorbate and adsorbent, these two are held by, so this is considered, this is an adsorbent, and the species which accumulate on the surface of the adsorbent, they are called adsorbate. The adsorbate and adsorbent, these two are held by weak van der Waals force. Due to the presence of this weak van der Waals force between what here? Adsorbate and adsorbent, this type of or this kind of adsorption is called what here? Physisorption. That means what here? Physisorption, it is a adsorption phenomenon where the adsorbate and adsorbent are held by a weak van der Waals force of attraction. So that is called what here? Physisorption or physical adsorption. See here. The physisorption means the adsorption, it is an adsorption in which adsorbate and adsorbent held by weak van der Waals force of attraction is called physisorption or physical adsorption. That means the adsorbate and adsorbent held by weak van der Waals force. Now I will move for the second one type, that is chemical adsorption. Now chemical adsorption, it is a phenomenon or it is an adsorption process in which adsorbate and adsorbent are held by a strong chemical bonds. Okay, the nature of binding force is what here? The binding force present between adsorbate and adsorbents is a strong chemical bond. So that is called what here? Chemical adsorption. Whereas in case of physical adsorption, the force of attraction present between adsorbate and adsorbent is weak van der Waals force. Hence the is called what here? Physical adsorption. Hence the definition of chemical adsorption, it is a adsorption phenomenon, adsorption in which adsorbate and adsorbent held by strong chemical bond is called chemical adsorption or chemisorption. So for example, for physisorption, so I have given already accumulation of ammonia gases on surface of what here? Charcoal. Here the charcoal act as an adsorbent and ammonia gases act as an adsorbate, and this is an example for the physisorption. So chemical adsorption example is adsorption of H2 on platinum, or another one example, adsorption of N2 on tungsten. See here, in case of chemical adsorption, there is a chemical reaction can be takes place. There is a change in the surface of the adsorbent. There is a formation of product can be takes place. But in case of physisorption, there is no any formation of water product. There is no any chemical reaction will be takes place. Just it is an physisorption. It is an just enanthila bodantare. Reversible reaction will be takes place. But here what happened in case of chemical adsorption, it is an irreversible process, because in chemical adsorption there is a formation of what here product can be takes place. There is a change in the chemical composition. There is a reaction will be takes place in case of what here? Chemical adsorption. So these are the definitions of what here? Physical adsorption and chemical adsorption. Okay, so we will move for the difference between physisorption and chemisorption. Difference between physisorption and chemisorption. So first one, I will write the difference between physisorption and chemisorption. Difference between physisorption and chemisorption. Difference, chemisorption. Okay, so first I will write here physisorption, and here I will write chemisorption. Difference between physical adsorption or chemical adsorption. Okay, so the first one, physical adsorption case, we know that physical adsorption, in which what happened, adsorbate and adsorbent held by weak van der Waals force. So this is the first, first difference. Here it involves weak van der Waals force of attraction. Force of attraction between, already we know the definition, that is first difference. Physisorption, here what happened? The adsorbate and adsorbent held by what here? Weak van der Waals force between adsorbate and adsorbent. Here what happened in case of chemisorption, already we know that, which involves chemical bond. bond between adsorbate and adsorbent. The definition only the first difference. Okay, next one, this is an reversible process. Physics option is an reversible process, because already we know that any gas which accumulate on the surface of the any adsorbent, because here the van der Waals force is an inversial, and physical adsorption which do not involve any chemical reactions, so there is no any chemical change in the composition, so for that reason there is no formation of any product, hence the physics option, it is an reversible process, whereas in case of chemical adsorption there is a reaction will be takes place, there is a change in the chemical composition, there is a formation of a product. That means what here, the once we get the product we will not get back any reactants, so in case of what here, chemisorption, hence this chemisorption is an irreversible process, it is an irreversible process, chemisorption. Okay, here the third one difference, low temperature is favorable. So in case of physics option, low temperature is favorable, as we discussed in just now, as increase in temperature molecule easily get escape, though this is in case of what here, physics option, but whereas in chemis option, to increase the rate of a reaction, to get more product we have to increase what here, temperature. That means what here, chemis option that require what here, high temperature, but here physics option the low temperature is favorable, in case of chemis option the high temperature is favorable. So next one, third one, enthalpy of adsorption is low. So that means what here, energy of adsorption is low, around 20 to 40 kJ per mole. So this is the energy of adsorption or enthalpy of adsorption, it is low in case of what here, physics option, whereas in case of chemis option the enthalpy of adsorption is high, around that is 80 to 240 kJ per mole. So the energy of adsorption is high in case of what here, chemisorption, so around 80 to 240 kJ per mole, whereas in case of physics option the enthalpy of adsorption is very low, around 20 to 40 kJ per mole. The last one difference, the physics option which forms what here, multilayer formation of here in case of chemis option monolayer will be formed in case of chemis option. See here, the in case of physics option the van der Waals force of attraction present between what here, adsorbate and adsorbent. That means what here, the van der Waals force which operate beyond the monolayer, consider this is a first layer and the force of attraction is van der Waals force of attraction, so this force of attraction which operate beyond the monolayer, hence there is a formation of what here, second layer, and which operate this layer also, so hence there is a formation of what here, many layer. So in case of what here, physics option, the formation of multi-layer is due to what here, the van der Waals force of attraction is that operate beyond the monolayer, hence there is a formation of what here, many layer, whereas in case of chemis option there is a formation of only one layer, that is monolayer, because once there is a formation of a product, we know that in chemis option the adsorbate and adsorbent are held by a chemical bond, that means there is a reaction can be occurred and there is a change in the chemical composition, So after reaction occur, after there is a formation of product, there is a change in the surface area, there is a change in the chemical composition. So for that reason, so after changing this surface area, so after changing the chemical composition of this surface area, there is no formation of what here, second layer, in case of what here, chemisorption. Due to reaction, the surface area, it changes its composition and its nature. So for that reason, there is no formation of second layer. Hence, in case of chemisorption, we are going to observe only one layer. In case of physisorption, we are going to observe multi-layer. So because of the van der Waals force, which operate beyond the monolayer. The last one difference, the physisorption is non-specific in nature, specific in nature, because the van der Waals force is an universal force. Any gas which accumulate on the surface of the any adsorbent. So whereas the chemical adsorption, it is an specific in nature. So where there is a possibility of formation of particular product, where there is a possibility of formation of particular reactions, so at that time only a particular gas or particular molecular species which accumulate on the particular of the surface of the adsorbent. So that's why the chemisorption is an specific in nature and this is non-specific in nature. So with this I will stop here. We will continue tomorrow. So thank you.
Hello everyone. Welcome to the Royal Palace PU College online classes. So in last class we have discussed about the types of adsorption. So there are mainly two types, physisorption and chemisorption, and the difference between physisorption and chemisorption. In today's session, so I am going to continue the same unit, adsorption isotherm. So now here the adsorption isotherm. In 1909, the Frauenlich given a relation between amount of gas absorbed per mass of the adsorbent and versus equilibrium. He got some curves. So that curves are called what here? Adsorption isotherm. Now here I will plot one graph. So that is x by m versus p. So p is an equilibrium pressure, x by m is an rate of adsorption. So here after plotting this graph, they will get what here, some curves. Now the temperature here 195 Kelvin and this is 244 Kelvin and this is 273 Kelvin. So here what happened, the curves are obtained when we plot the graph x by m versus p. So here the adsorption isotherm means the curves which are obtained when the plotting of graph between amount of gas absorbed amount of the adsorbent at equilibrium pressure. Now here adsorption isotherm means a curves obtained by plotting graph between rate of adsorption. So that is rate of adsorption is x by m versus equilibrium pressure. So that curves are called what here? Adsorption isotherm. Okay, so the curves which are obtained on plotting a graph that is x by m, that is rate of adsorption versus p, so we will get what here, some curves. So these curves are called what here? Adsorption isotherm. Now here the adsorption isotherm equation given by the Frauenlich, that is equation is x by m equal to kp raised to 1 by n. X by m equal to kp raised to 1 by n, where the value of n is greater than 1. Here the x is amount of gas, amount of adsorbate. Here gas act as an adsorbate, and m is mass of the adsorbent. Mass of the adsorbent. And P is pressure, equilibrium pressure. And K and N are the constant values. These values depends on the nature of the adsorbate and adsorbent. Now here, so X is amount of adsorbate, M is mass of the adsorbent, P is equilibrium pressure, K and N are the constant values. These values depends on the nature of the adsorbate and adsorbent. Now by taking log on both the sides, that will becomes what here? Log X by M. So here log X by M equal to log K plus 1 by N log P. Log P. By taking the log on the both sides for the equation 1. So we'll get what here? Log X by M, that is equal to log K plus log 1 by n log p. So here what happened? The straight line equation, the Brownlee adsorption isotherm, this can be verified by plotting graph, that is log x by m versus log p. So we'll get what here? Straight line. So here what happened? At higher pressure we have a deviations, and this is an intercept, that is equal to what here? Log K. So here slope, that is slope equal to, on plotting the slope, that is slope equal to 1 by n. The 1 by n values varies between 0 to 1. Probable range is what here? 0.1 to 0.5. So this is Brownlee adsorption isotherm. So here the adsorption isotherm means the curves obtained by plotting a graph, that is X by M versus P. X by M is rate of adsorption. Now P is an equilibrium pressure. So here what happened? This graph indicates what here? So here look at here, on increasing the temperature, the rate of adsorption, that will get what here? Decreases. Here at 195 Kelvin, the adsorption, rate of adsorption is more. So on increasing the temperature, that is 195 to 244 Kelvin, the rate of adsorption becomes less compared to this 195 Kelvin. The 244 Kelvin, at 244 Kelvin temperature, the rate of adsorption decreases. Again, by increasing the temperature, at 273 Kelvin, again the rate of adsorption decreases. This graph indicates what here? On increasing the temperature, rate of adsorption is decreases. On increasing the temperature, rate of adsorption is decreases. Now here, so however, one more point, this graph indicates what here? So on increasing the pressure, the adsorption, that will becomes that reaches almost saturation. Now here what happens? Starting, there is an increase in the rate of the adsorption at lower pressure is more, but on increasing the pressure, what happened? The rate of adsorption approach almost saturation. So there is no sudden increase in the rate of adsorption at higher pressure. This graph indicates two important facts, that on increasing the temperature, the rate of adsorption becomes decreases. X by M, that will becomes decreases rate of adsorption. So how, and also on increasing the pressure, the rate of adsorption almost reaches what here? Saturation, almost approach to the saturation.
So this graph indicates this one. So the adsorption isotherm given by Brownlee, that equation is x by m, it is equal to kp raised to 1 by n. So x is an amount of gas absorbed. So amount of adsorbate, m is mass of the adsorbent, p is equilibrium pressure, and k and n are the constant. So these values depends on the nature of the adsorbate and adsorbent. By taking the log on both sides for the equation 1, so we will get what here. So log x by m equal to log k plus 1 by n log p. So the Brownlee adsorption equation is verified by plotting x by log x by m versus log p. We will get what here, straight line. So here what happened? The deviation, so deviation is due to what here? At higher pressure, the values will not fall on the straight line. So there is a deviation. So this is a demerits of what here? Brownlee adsorption isotherm. That means what here? The Brownlee adsorption isotherm, look at here, valid only at lower pressure. On increasing, what happened? There is a deviation. On increasing the pressure, there is a deviation. So this is the limitations of what here? Brownlee adsorption isotherm. The Brownlee adsorption isotherm valid only at the lower pressure but not at higher pressure. Okay, so now here let us, I will move for the one more, that is concept.